Hi students, I hope all are safe and doing good. Okay, it's better stay at home and be safe students. Okay, so this second wave of this pandemic, it has become very much difficult for us to survive. Okay, so let us take some precautionary measures in order to fight this pandemic. So I do not have to introduce about myself. Okay, already I have taken two subjects, okay, like corporate accounting and advanced corporate accounting in my previous semesters, but I took a break for fifth semester, and then I'm handling this management accounting for your sixth semester as such. But missing you all students, and missing the classroom teaching also, of course. But it has become inevitable for us to go for this virtual classroom teaching since the college reopens. Okay, but still we'll see to it that the classroom, that it will be more or less like a classroom teaching, okay, wherein you will be not be missing the classroom teaching. One more thing that I would like to tell you students is that this first chapter that you have, that is introduction to management accounting, I'm going to teach this subject, okay, teach these topics or cover these topics with the help of PowerPoint presentations, okay. But the remaining aspects, okay, wherein we need to solve the problem, this first chapter is purely theoretical, okay. When it comes to solving the problems, I will make use of one app called as FreeCam, okay. So wherein I can scan the document, that is especially the problems and also the solution, and then I can easily teach you in that app, okay. So PowerPoint presentation is highly difficult students, okay. So I expect your cooperation, okay. If you have any doubts, okay, either you can discuss or put your, raise your questions in WhatsApp group, or you can just personally text me about your problems, okay. So with regarding to my teaching, or if you have any doubt in following my lecture as such, okay. Hopefully with this introduction, okay, I would like to start with this first session wherein I'm going to discuss about the syllabus of management accounting students, okay. Let me brief you all about management accounting syllabus, okay. So the unit number one that you have is introduction to management accounting, and this will be for 12 hours, okay, wherein I'm going to discuss you about how this management accounting came into existence, okay. There are three branches of accounting, as you all know: financial accounting, cost accounting, and management accounting. So management accounting is the third branch of accounting, okay. So this year I have to discuss about the nature and scope of management accounting, and also management accounting, then relationship that exists between financial accounting and management accounting, and similarly the relationship that exists between cost accounting and management accounting. So I'm not going to explain in detail as to about these things in my introduction chapter, okay. When I come to the next session, okay, session number 2, I'm going to go in depth about this management accounting. So one thing you remember students, why management accounting was introduced was to overcome the limitations of financial accounting and cost accounting, okay. And there are three branches of accounting: financial accounting and cost accounting, then the third one is management accounting. Cost accounting was introduced to overcome some of the limitations of financial accounting, and similarly management accounting was introduced to overcome the limitations of both financial accounting and cost accounting. So majority of the limitations of cost accounting is being overcome by management accounting, okay. So with this introduction, okay, I'm going to tell you the what are the drawbacks of financial accounting and cost accounting, which is being overcome by management accounting, okay. So one thing that I can say is, in financial accounting, it records only quantitative aspect. What do you mean by quantitative aspect? Which can be expressed in terms of numbers. But management accounting, it takes not only a quantitative data but also qualitative data. What do you mean by qualitative data? Those data which cannot be expressed in numbers. So to overcome one of this limitation of financial accounting, management accounting was introduced, okay. So likewise, we have so many drawbacks of financial accounting and cost accounting, which is overcome by management accounting, okay. So in this chapter, I'm going to discuss about the relationship that exists between cost accounting and management accounting, and also financial accounting and management accounting. Then the next, another part of this chapter is that I need to work out problems on analysis of financial statements, students, okay. Here we need to analyze the financial statements. Whenever we make use of the word financial statements, it is understood that it includes profit and loss account, which is also called as income statement, and then balance sheet, of course, it is called as a position statement as on today, okay. So here I am going to discuss you about the various types of analysis that you have. Okay, so it may be either internal analysis or external analysis. All these are theoretical part which I am going to explain it to you in detail. Okay, and then I will come to the methods of financial analysis. Okay, there are different methods of financial analysis. First method you have is comparative analysis, second one common size analysis, and third one trend analysis. So under comparative analysis, we have two types, students: comparative balance sheet analysis and comparative income statement analysis. And coming to common size, we have two types, that is common size balance sheet analysis and common size income statement analysis. And all these differences you'll just come to know when I discuss about the format. Okay, and then here in this chapter, the main thing is that interpretation part plays a very vital role. Why? Because calculation, everything is easy, students. Okay, there is a different format that we have to follow for calculating the items. Okay, so the format of calculating or the procedure for calculating the percentages will vary from comparative to common size. The only thing is we have to concentrate on format. But what is more important? Interpretation. So the interpretation that we are going to give for comparative and also for common size and also for trend analysis, of course, is entirely different. So we have to concentrate on interpretation portion. Okay, but even in the exam also, if they ask you for the interpretation, if you just give your interpretation overall or in few points, it is more than sufficient. Okay. And it is the place, this is the chapter wherein you can earn, that is, you can score good marks. Okay, why? Because it is very easy, any person can understand this. Okay, as I told you, provided you give importance to interpretation. Okay, so this is unit number one, students. Okay, the next unit number two, of course, is called as ratio analysis. Okay, so this ratio analysis covers nearly 14 hours, students. Okay, so the thing is that here it is a very vast chapter as such. The thing is, you have different types of ratios that I need to discuss here. We have different formulas also. By adding the formulas and then using those formulas and calculating the all types of ratios is a very challenging task here. Okay, and then after calculating some of the ratios, we need to prepare even the balance sheet, and also if possible we need to complete this income statement if it is incomplete. Okay, so in this chapter, I need to discuss about the meaning and what do you mean by a ratio. You know how to express the ratios, okay? Then we have classification of ratios, okay? There are different classification of ratios. Those ratios we need to learn. And what are the uses of these ratios, calculating the ratios, how it is useful to the management in taking some important decisions. And of course, the limitations of this ratio analysis, which I'm going to discuss in my theoretical aspect, okay? And coming to the meaning and types of ratio analysis, again I have to discuss about what do you mean by ratio analysis and ratio is different from ratio analysis. Okay, so and then I have to discuss about meaning of ratio analysis, then actual working of the problems under the classification of ratios, namely we have liquidity ratios, profitability ratios, and solvency ratios. Okay, so liquidity ratios are really short term liquidity ratios and long term liquidity ratios. Baruthe students, alli short term alli yavudadu, long term alli yavudadu annadanna discuss madbeka anta I am going to discuss in detail about all these ratios. For example, short term anta bandre we have current ratio, liquidity ratio, etc. Current ratio, it is a ratio which expresses the relationship between current assets and current liabilities. So only you have a standard ratio called as 2:1. Okay, I'm going to explain with you while solving the problem. Okay, standard ratio, kelu ratio age standard ratio is iruthe students, but kelu ratio age standard ratio is irodilla. Only it is very difficult to give the interpretation, but only you have standard ratios, it is very easy to judge the ratios and judge the financial position of the company. So this is one of the drawback of this ratio analysis, which I'm going to discuss in one of the limitations of ratio analysis. Okay, and then coming to long term solvency ratios, only you have like debt equity ratios, net fixed assets turnover ratio, then proprietary ratio. All these are called as long term solvency ratios, which again, long term solvency andre, for example, outsiders funds to shareholders funds, okay, or long term debt to shareholders debt. So idanna we are going to express in terms of long term ratios. Okay, long term debt ratio antanu karitare. Okay, Again, coming back to this profitability ratios, the second one, any ratios which are expressed to the profits is called as profitability ratios. Only you have gross profit ratio, net profit ratio, operating profit ratio. So all these are the different types of profitability ratios which I am going to discuss over there. Okay. Then you have solvency ratios. Only turnover ratios also is there. Okay. So that is turnover ratios. You have stock turnover ratio, inventory turnover ratio, debtors turnover ratio, creditors turnover ratio. All these are the different types of turnover ratios which we are going to express in terms of turnover. Turnover is nothing but sales, or sometimes if sales information is not given, then we are going to express in terms of CGS. Okay, what is CGS? It is nothing but cost of goods sold. Okay, so if we work out problems on all these classification of ratios, then this chapter will be over, students, but this chapter I'm going to keep it in the end, okay? So that the college reopens, and then wherein actually I can work out the problems on the board, which makes you people very much easier for you to understand, okay? So coming to the third unit, it is fund flow analysis, okay? After this first unit, okay, I'm going to start with fund flow analysis, students. Okay, then I'm going to start with this, continue with the cash flow statement, cash flow analysis, wherein it is quite that is related to this fund flow analysis. If you understand this fund flow analysis, cash flow analysis is very easy. Why? Because the preparation of ledger accounts, everything will be the same both for cash flow and fund flow statement, except few changes, okay, which I'm going to notify you when I start with the chapters. Okay, fund flow analysis, nowadays whenever we say that that is managing funds, okay, it is a challenging task from the point of the management as such. Whenever we use the word funds, which means that it is nothing but the flow of funds in the organization. Flow and the takshana, there are two types of flow, students, inflow and outflow. Okay, inflow andre when the funds are coming into the organization, outflow means when the funds are moving out of the organization. So fund flow analysis alli meaning of fund odbekante definition I'm going to discuss, and also the uses and limitations of fund flow analysis athava fund flow statement. It is also called as fund flow statement. And then I'm going to discuss the what are the differences between cash flow statement and also fund flow statement. Okay, then the procedure for preparing fund flow statement. There are different steps to for the steps you have to follow while preparing fund flow statement, students. Steps nella nannu chapter discuss madidaga in detail agi what are the steps to be followed annodanna nanu heltini. Ivaga helidru nimge artha agodilla. There are different steps. First, now schedule of changes in working capital anta prepare madbekante. Second, ledger accounts prepare madbekante. Okay, ledger accounts we have to prepare only for those accounts wherein the adjustments are given. ಎಲ್ಲದಕ್ಕೂ ಲೆಜ್ಜರ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡೋ ಅವಶ್ಯಕತೆ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ, ಲೈಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಈ ಡಿವಿಡೆಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಪೋಸ್ ಡಿವಿಡೆಂಡ್ಗೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಮತ್ತು ಪ್ರೊವಿಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸೇಷನ್ಗೆ ಅದು ಲೆಜ್ಜರ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ. ಅಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಏನಾದರೂ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ, ಡೆಪ್ರಿಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ಅಸೆಟ್ಸ್ಗೆ, ಆವಾಗ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಅಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಏನೋ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರಿಂಗ್ ಶೆಡ್ಯೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಇನ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್. ಏನಕ್ಕೆ ಇದನ್ನು ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂದರೆ, ಟು ನೋ ನೆಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್. ಕಂಪನಿಲಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಇದೆಯೋ, ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಇದೆಯೋ, ಅದನ್ನು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಕೆ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಶೆಡ್ಯೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಇನ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್. ಆ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು, ಲೆಜ್ಜರ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಯಾವಾಗ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ವೆನ್ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗಿವನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಟು ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್, ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಫಂಡ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫಂಡ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಇದೆಯೋ, ಫಂಡ್ಸ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಇದೆಯೋ, ಅದನ್ನು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಕೆ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಟು ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಫಂಡ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಎಂಡ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಟು ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಫಂಡ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ದ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕ್ ವೇರಿನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ easily tally this fund flow statement, students. Fund flow statement is prepared in a T form, wherein we have to show sources and application. In the end, balance sheet tara idu tally aagbeku. Sources side en amount barutho, application side allo same amount bandre, then your problem is correct. Okay, so nan en helthini andre, technique nan helkodana follow madidre, definitely I will tell you in the end, adjusted profit and loss account and fund flow statement eradunu simultaneously prepare madidre, students, then definitely if you follow the procedure that I say, then your fund flow statement will easily tally, wherein there are no chances of missing any items. Okay, so this is the fund flow statement. So idana now problem workout madadaga innu detail agi nan explain martini. Okay, this is unit number 3. Then coming to unit number 4, that is cash flow. Okay, so cash flow statementally, it is also Yuvaga, as on today, whenever we talk about financial statement, cash flow statement is also included under financial statement, students. Okay, you just do remember this. Okay, so cash flow statement is a very important statement which is prepared by most of the large scale business organization to have a check on the flow of cash. Okay, so illu kuda I am going to discuss about the cash, meaning of cash and cash equivalents, and what are the uses of cash flow statement, and also of course the limitations of cash flow statement. Okay, so it is said that as per the accounting standard 7, there is a particular procedure that we have to follow in preparing cash flow statement. Okay, so cash flow from, there are three headings, okay students. Okay, one though, cash flow from operating activities, cash flow from investing activities, and cash flow from financing activities. More head alli navu prepare martivi cash flow statement. One, I am repeating, cash flow from operating activities. Illi yavudid barutte antandre, that is like whatever items that we show in income statement, both expenses and income, idellanu illi barutte. Okay, and apart from that, any increase or decrease in current assets and current liabilities adu kuda illi barutte. Okay, so fund flow alli navu en martivi, one schedule anta prepare martivi separate. It is called as I told you, schedule of changes in working capital. But illi cash flow statement alli aa schedule prepare madodilla, but provided all those changes in current assets and current liabilities will be incorporated in operating activities along with expenses and income. So adanna in detail agi nan ee chapter shuru madda heltini. So cash flow statement is prepared with the help of three head, students. I am repeating, one do cash flow from operating activities. Okay, idana helide nan expenses and incomes of income statement, along with that an increase or decrease in that is current assets and current liabilities, all those will be incorporated, but provided I am going to give you the format. Okay, a format alli innu detail agi I am going to explain it to you. Then you have cash flow from investing activities. Illi now we have to incorporate all those changes that takes place on the asset side of the balance sheet, like all fixed assets. Okay, so purchase athwa sale of fixed asset idra adnella incorporate martivi investing activities alli. Okay, ee tara napka idkondre, then you will come to know what are the items that you have to show in operating, and what are the items should be incorporated in investing, and also of course in financing activities. Third head bandu cash flow from financing activities. Illi ನಾವು ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಶೀಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆಲ್ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟೀಸ್, ಓಕೆ, ಯಾವ್ದ್ಯಾವ್ದು ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಲೋನ್ಸ್ ಬಾರೋಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್, ಅಥವಾ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಶೇರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್, ಡಿಬೆಂಚರ್ಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಐಟಮ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಶೋನ್ ಓವರ್ ಇಯರ್. ಇನ್ಕ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅಕಸ್ಮಾತ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಆವಾಗ ನಾವು ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಕೆಟ್. ಅಕಸ್ಮಾತ್ ರಿಡೆಮ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದರೆ, ಸಾರಿ ರಿಡೆಮ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಬೆಂಚರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಬಂದರೆ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಆಚೆ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ, ಆವಾಗ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ದ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ವಿತಿನ್ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಕೆಟ್ಸ್, ಅಥವಾ ಇಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಅಂತನಾದ್ರೂ ಬರಿಬೋದು. ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ಪ್ಲಸ್, ಮತ್ತು ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ಮೈನಸ್, ಅಥವಾ ಮೈನಸ್ ಅಂತ ಬರೆಯೋದ್ರ ಬದಲು ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಪುಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಕೆಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಸಿಂಗ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲನೂ ಅಷ್ಟೇ, ಆಪರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಗಲಿ, ಫೈನಾನ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಗಲಿ, ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಗಲಿ, ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ವಿತೌಟ್ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಕೆಟ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಬರಿತೀವಿ, ವೆನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ವಿತೌಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಕೆಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಈ ಮೂರು ಹೆಡ್ಡು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಕರೆಕ್ಟಾಗಿ ಅರ್ಥ ಆದರೆ, ದೆನ್ ಆಟೋಮೆಟಿಕಲಿ ಇವಾಗ ನಮಗೆ ಏನು ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಇನ್ ದ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ದಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇಯರ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಆನ್ಸರ್, ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಟ್ಯಾಲಿ ವಿತ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಇನ್ ಯೋರ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಶೀಟ್. ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಶೀಟಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋ ಕ್ಲೋಸಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶು ನಾವು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋ ಕ್ಲೋಸಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಟ್ಯಾಲಿ ಆದರೆ, ದೆನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪರ್ಫೆಕ್ಟ್. Okay, so again here also in this chapter I am going to tell you students as to the procedure that you have to follow while preparing cash flow statement. A procedure follow madadre definitely your cash flow statement will be tallied within few minutes, wherein there are no chances of missing any items. Okay, but the thing is you have to follow the procedures. So the last unit that you have is management reporting, students. This is fully theory. Okay, so meaning of management reporting andre enu anta odbekagutte, requisites of a good reporting. Management report andre management accountant at the end of the year or whenever it is required by the management avaga pade pade report na submit martane. So aa report submit madbekare yav tara report baribeku, what type of reports should be prepared, how the report should be prepared by management accountant, adanna navu illi ee chapter alli othivi. It is fully theoretical. Okay, and I am going to discuss to a draft, okay, and a specimen of the draft of a report of a management accountant, okay, which may be asked in the exam. Okay, ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಎಸೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಗುಡ್ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟಿಂಗ್, ಗುಡ್ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಯಾವ ಥರ ಇರಬೇಕು, ಓಕೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಗುಡ್ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟಿಂಗ್, ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡ್ರಾಫ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್. ಒಂದು ಎರಡು ಮೂರು ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ಗೆ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಯುವರ್ ಓನ್ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಪರ್ ದ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ದ ಆಲ್ ದ ಫೈವ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಫೈವ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ಸ್. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಎ ಬ್ರೀಫ್ ಐಡಿಯಾ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಸಿಲೆಬಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಡೋಂಟ್ ವರಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಸಿಲೆಬಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಆಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಮೈ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಅರ್ಲಿಯೆಸ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಏನು ಕೇಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ವರ್ಚುವಲ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್, ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಡೂ, ನಾನು ಸ್ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಡ್ ಕಾಪಿ ಕಳಿಸ್ತೀನಿ, ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್, ಈ ಚಾಪ್ಟ್ರದ್ದು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಕಳಿಸ್ತೀನಿ, ಅದನ್ನು ನೀವು ಬರ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಆದರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಔಟ್ ದ ಪ್ರಿಂಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಯು. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಪ್ರಿಂಟ್ ಔಟ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡು ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೂ ಸರಿ, ಬರೆಯೋದೇನು ಬೇಕಾಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಔಟ್ ದ ಪ್ರಿಂಟ್ ಔಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಯು. ಓಕೆ, ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ ಲಾಕ್ಡೌನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಆರ್ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಪರ್ಮಿಟ್ಸ್ ಯು. ಓಕೆ, ಅದಾದಮೇಲೆ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಎನಿ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಗಿವ್ ಎನಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗಾನ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ವಿಡಿಯೋ. ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೈ ಸಿನ್ಸಿಯರ್ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್. ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಹಾಗೆ ಆಯಿತು, ಸೊ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ದೇ ಡಿಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೋ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್, ಬಟ್ ದೇ ಅಗೇನ್ ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ಡ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಟು ರೀಕ್ಯಾಪ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅದನ್ನು ತಿರುಗಿ ಹೇಳಬೇಕಾದ ಸಂಬಂಧ ಅಂದರೆ ಸಂದರ್ಭ ಬಂದಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಟು ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ದ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇವಾಗ ಹೇಗಿದ್ರು ಫ್ರೀ ಇರ್ತೀರಾ, ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್ ನೋಡಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಥಿಯರಿ ಏನಾರು ಇದ್ರೂ, ಎನಿ ಹೌ ಯು ಕಮ್ ಟು ಫೈನಲ್ ಇಯರ್, ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಕೀಪ್ ದ ಜೆರಾಕ್ಸ್ ಕಾಪಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಯರಿ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವ್ಯೂ, ಅದನ್ನು ಓದ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಸಾಕು. ಓಕೆ, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಮೋರ್ ದೆನ್ ಸಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯು ಪೀಪಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಅಂದರೆ ನಾನು ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ಸು ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕೋಆಪ್ರೇಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಬಂದರೆ, ಓಕೆ, ದಿ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಕಮ್ ಟು ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ನೀವು ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗೋದು ಓನ್ಲಿ ವೆನ್ ಐ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ದ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಕಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ಒನ್ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ 2 years ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರಿಂಗ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯಾರಿಟಿವ್. ಸೊ ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರು ಒಂದು ಕಂಪನಿದು ನೀವು ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಕಂಪ್ಯಾರಿಟಿವ್ ಅನಾಲಿಸಿಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ. ಅದನ್ನು ನಾನು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ, ಆವಾಗ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಈಸಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನು ಅದೇ ಥರ ಕಾಮನ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಅನಾಲಿಸಿಸ್ ಹೇಗೆ ಮಾಡೋದು ಅದನ್ನು ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಟ್ಟ ಮೇಲೆ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ದಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಂಗ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋಸ್. ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಅನಾಲಿಸಿಸ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಂಗ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋಸ್ ನೀವೇ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಸಾಲ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ, ಲಾಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಸಾಲ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ, ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ರೇಷಿಯೋಸ್, ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ನೀವೇ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಶೀಟ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋಸ್, ಟರ್ನ್ಓವರ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋಸ್ ಅಂತ ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದು ರೇಷಿಯೋಸ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ನಾನು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ನೀವೇ ಒಂದು ಕೆಲವು ರೇಷಿಯೋಸ್ನ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಜಡ್ಜ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಸಾಲ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್, ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಂಪನಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಡ್ರಾಫ್ಟ್ ಎ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ ಎನಿ ಕ್ರೈಸಿಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎನ್ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರೂ ಒಂದು ಕ್ರೈಸಿಸ್ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಅವಾಗ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಎ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಕೌಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕಂಪನಿ, ಹೌ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಾಫ್ಟ್ ಎ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟ್. ಇದು ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಬಂದಾಗ ಡ್ರಾಫ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಎ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಹೇಗೆ ಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ನೀವು ಒಂದು ಸಂದರ್ಭ ತೊಗೊಂಡು ದೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಾಫ್ಟ್ ಎ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟೆಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಡಿಸ್ಕಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಿಲೆಬಸ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಎ ಹೋಲ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಆಮೇಲೆ ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಐ ಆಮ್ ರೆಫರಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಟೂ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬುಕ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಎಮ್ ಎನ್ ಅರೋರಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮತ್ತು ಆರ್ ಕೆ ಶರ್ಮಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಶಶಿಕೆ ಗುಪ್ತಾ. ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಆರ್ ಗುಡ್ ಬುಕ್ಸ್, ಓಕೆ, ಫಾರ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಬುಕ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಎನಫ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೀ ಟು ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ದ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಫಾರ್ ಯು ಪೀಪಲ್ ಟು attend the exams. Okay, so whatever we are doing, okay, not only from the exam point of view, inno extra problems, as you all know, I don't go for our teaching only from the examination point of view, inno that is extra knowledge bekaguvanta ella problems nu with all the adjustments I'm going to teach you students. Okay, that assurance I can give from my part. Okay, I hope students you all have understood this. Okay, with this I'm going to end this PowerPoint presentation. Thank you one and all.